Hi, hello. So, hope you people are doing well and great. Anyway, have a good day and good morning. We people are discussing about spatial analysis in GIS. Basic spatial analysis, that basic tools to analyze certain points, polyline and polygon. See, I always repeat the word point, polyline, polygon. See, it is very important. That is the very basic spatial entities is on a map, right? And I always tell you that cartography is the heart of geography, and GIS is the heart of cartography. And we people are doing different kinds of things with the help of different kinds of machines. Machines including software and the oriented so that sorry, oriented hardware and software, that means computer. So we already learn about basic spatial analysis techniques, that is overlay analysis, buffer analysis, and network analysis. You people are already going through the video. Hope you people are have done that. And you can ask your doubts, right? So remember, always remember the facts. We people are trying to extract the pattern, process, and spatial behavior, right? The basic aim and objective of the GIS is to study about the Earth different phenomenal pattern, how the phenomena are rolling down, what are the changes, how the changes are affecting the human. That's why it's known as the science of what, where, and why. So we people are what? Using the locational intelligence to resolve certain issues, certain problems around us, right? That real world technology, that we are applying certain technology for finding resolution, finding how to resolve the issues. So today's topic, that is, it is also some kinds of analysis. But this tool, this is known as spatial interpolation. There are certain so this in broad category, spatial interpolation, and certain subsets that small tools in that broad category. And from that word interpolation, hope you know that you have already done how to interpolate the contours. Fine. That is the basic math. You know that how to trace the contour and how to generate contours from spot heights. There are certain formulas and all those things, those kinds of basic statistics and mathematical methods. You know that, right? It is also clearly connected with that spatial function, that tracing contours, tracing spot heights. So the spatial interpolation is clearly connected with that kinds of manual operation. See, here we people are doing just what? We are doing with the help of machines. Machine here means, what I mean machine mean? Here machine means software and hardware, that is computer, right? That may be commercial or non-commercial or open source, right? So ESRI is RGA is an commercial one, and open source QGIS, GRASS, etc. So let us start our session. So welcome to my video lesson, spatial interpolation. So how the introduction session, spatial interpolation is the estimation the value of properties at unsampled sites within the area covered by existing observation. So remember that old work, that manual work, we are giving certain spot heights, and you people are making certain contours based on that height. There are, see, actually we people are just drawing the contour or something that isotherms or isobar, but actually it is based on certain calculations. I don't know how many of you have done that calculation. In my graduation, me also not gone through that calculation. Also, we are just drawing that contours. Fine, equal lines. So here, that is the simple. That means unsampled sides. That we have done with the help of that tracing sheet, tracing paper, and spot heights. And we people are just drawing the contours with the help of pencil. Usual rationally, points close together are more likely to have similar values than points of far apart. That Tobler's law. Tobler's law is the second law of geography. The near one are more related. See, there are certain laws, certain concepts, and certain tradition. Themes, concepts, traditions, and laws in geography. See, Tobler's law means here laws in geography. Just Google it, you can find out. See, I think you people are already learning that development of geography thought, DGT. Fine. What is that Tobler's law? How that usual rationing, points close together are more likely to have similar values than points far apart. So that is the basic law that is connected with near ones are more related. That is the Tobler's law. Use of spatial interpolation in GIS provides contours for displaying data graphically. Calculate some property of the surface at given point. Compare data of different types, units in different data layers. So classification of interpolators, that is area point, global, local, exact, approximate, deterministic, stochastic, gradual, abrupt. Area-based interpolation, given a set of data mapped on the on one set of source zones, determine the value of a different set of target zones. For example, given population counts for census tracts, estimate population for electoral districts, vegetation and soil map. Certain how the area-based interpolation is working. Area-based interpolation, centroid. Centroid is nothing, it is just creating a central point based on certain polygon. It is just a click. See, in machine, it is just click. Fine. Centroid, find centroid of an area, central point of a polygon. Assign total value of data in an area to centroid, treat as a point interpolation. Overlay, see, I already explained what is the overlay analysis. See, here is also certain that interpolation is also, there are certain overlay interpolations also there. Overlay of target and some zones. Determine the proportion of each source zone that is assigned to each target zone. A portion of the total value of the attribute for each source zone to target zones. Fine. Point-based interpolation. That is, you have done that contour. Or what you see, we can do that based on certain isotherms, isobars, etc. Fine. Similarly, it is similar to that you people have done that. Not you people, we people have done that based on tracing sheet and pencil. Given points whose locations and values are known, determine the values of other points at locations. For example, weather stations readings, spot heights, porosity measurements. Already said that. Spot heights, right? Global versus local interpolators. Global interpolators determine a single location, which is mapped across the whole region. Example, trend surface. Local interpolators apply an algorithm repeatedly to a small portion of the total set of points. Inverse distance weighted. See, I will explain what is that inverse distance. Exact versus approximate interpolation.
xi interpolation honor all data points, example inverse distance weighted. Approximate interpolation, try to approach the all data points, trend surface. Deterministic was stochastic. Deterministic interpolation model, a data point at a particular position, example spline. Stochastic interpolation, try to model probability of a set of a data point being at a particular position, example Krigging Fourier analysis. Find that Fourier, that is a name of mathematician. Okay, gradual abrupt interpolators. Gradual interpolators assume continuous and smooth behavior of data everywhere. Abrupt interpolators allow for sudden changes in data to boundaries or unidentified diversities. Derivatives. That means deviations. Example of interpolators, that is Thiessen polygon. See, these are the tools we are using to find certain interpolating method. I will show one example, not just a demonstration. I will show you the result. Output, I will show you the output result. Thiessen polygon, inverse distance weighted, that is IDW, that is known as IDW, spline. It is a type of contour generation. Radial basis functions, radial basis functions, global polynomial, Krigging. See here, in that Thiessen polygon, inverse distance weighted, splines and Krigging. See, these four operations I have done properly. See, I have used this one many times for different purpose, right? When I'm doing certain GIS projects, I have used these four options. But this radial basis functions and global polynomials, these two I have not used, fine. So all these four are very useful, and we can simply apply to any kinds of project, that BSc, MSc, or any bigger project. I have finished so many projects, and we have used these kinds of analysis tools, interpolation tools. Okay. So I will explain this all four, and remaining two also I will explain, but the four one, that Thiessen polygon, inverse distance weighted, spline and Krigging, this I have the practical knowledge and I have used several times, fine. And radial basis functions and global polynomial I have not used, so okay. So I will explain that theoretically, and if you are doing with the help of that RGS, it is just we are just giving that data, that vector data, or sometimes raster data, and it is just clicking two or three times. But the what is behind means what are the application, means what is happening behind, that is clearly connected with statistics and the theoretical geography, right? So just for one word explanation, that Thiessen polygon, that is for finding out certain areas of influence, for example hospital, for one hospital, and we can find out the areas of influence of that particular hospital, bank, schools, etc. So inverse distance weighted, that is for finding variations for generating certain contours or something. Spline is also spline and Krigging, that is all these three, inverse IDW, spline and Krigging, it's all three are somewhat similar. I will show you one example. Then Thiessen polygon, also called proximal method. This is the statistical formula. Attempts to weight data points by area, commonly used for precipitation data. Not just precipitation data, we will use this for a different purpose, right? We'll use this for different purpose. Inverse distance weighted, IDW, is essentially moving average methods estimates based upon proximity of points known as known data. Exact interpreter, the best results from IDWR are obtained when sampling is sufficiently dense with regard to the local variation you are attempting to simulate. If the sampling of the input point is sparse or very uneven, the results may not sufficiently represent the desired surface. See, I already said some part that what we people are doing with the help of that tracing sheet and pencil. So these are the explanation. I will provide you this slide and you can read this. Then splines, the mathematical equivalent of using a flexible ruler called a spline. Piecewise polynomials fit through data, local interpreter, can be used as an exact or approximate interpolator depending upon the degrees of freedom granted. Polynomial order, thus for smooth data sets, can cause wild fluctuation otherwise. Radial basis function, that is RBF, exact version of spline, like bending a sheet of rubber to pass through the points while minimizing the total curvature of the surface. It fits piecewise polynomial to a specified number of nearest input points while passing through the sample points. So this is also how radial RBF work. You read, I will provide this one and you have to read. Global polynomial, fit one polynomial through entire data set, advantages, creates very smooth surface, implies homogeneous behavior model of data set, disadvantages, higher order of polynomials may reach ridiculously large or small values outside the data area, susceptible to outline in the data. See, these are the explanation. Fine, you have to read it. Stochastic, geostatistical interpreters. Geostatistical techniques create. Geostatistical means geographical and statistical methods. These all interpolation methods are clearly connected with statistics. We geography people are using these methods for interpreting the data, spatial data. See, that's why you people are studying statistics as a subsidiary paper, right? Complementary paper. Geostatistical techniques create surface incorporating the statistical properties of the measured data, produces not only prediction of surface but uncertainty estimates of predictions. Many methods are associated with geostatistics, but they are all in the Krugging family. Krugging, developed by Georges Matron as the theory of regionalized variables, and D.G. Krug as an optimal method for interpolation for use of the mining industry. Right? Basis of the technique is the rate of which the variance between points changes over space. This is expressed in the variogram, which shows how the average difference between values at points changes with distance between points. So variogram, it's a variogram. It is also that connected with Krugging, that function. What is the functions working in the variogram? This is the variogram functions working in the Krugging. Deriving the variogram, right? Divides the range of distance into a set of discrete intervals. Example, 10 intervals between distance 0 and the maximum distance in the study area. For every pair of points, compute distance and score difference in values. Assign each pair or one of the distance ranges and accumulate total variance in each range. After every pair has been used, or sample of pairs in a large data set, compute the average variance in each distance range. plot these values at the midpoint distance of each range. It's all done by the machines, right? These are the statistical formulas applying for find out this Krigging or variogram, universal exponential circular. See, this, you know, this is clearly a practical session, you know. See, if you are doing a Krigging work with the help of certain points, generating certain vector data and analyzing, it is just easy. See, this theoretical class is a bit boring. Explaining things, these things are something, what to say, right? Summary of interpolators. So read this. See how the Thiessen polygon is created, right? Inverse distance weighting. These are the output result. We are doing this operation with the help of vector or raster data, and these kinds of output results we will get. Krigging. Clearly, you know that how that see, you can generate contour from this land, this surface. You can change the color or whatever it is. It is according to your choice. If it is possible, we will meet in the college after this issue, and I will show you how it works. Right. So conclusion: interpolation method depends upon character of data, your assumptions of the data behavior. When possible, best way to compare method is methods to try several methods. Make sure you understand theory, refine best method. So that's all about today's class. So it's something what explaining practical with just a video lesson. It is quite boring, I know. Kindly go through the what lesson and try to see some other more videos, and you can ask your doubt, right? I will try to clear your doubts. So remember, we people are studying about the space. That means space is constructed socially or culturally, and we are extracting, mining certain spatial patterns, spatial process and spatial behavior for better future. So thank you. Thanks for watching my lesson, video lesson. Thank you. Thanks a lot.